Greetings, everyone. With Palm Sunday, we enter into our most holy week as followers of the risen Christ. We call it Holy Week for a good reason, because the deepest aspects of our experience as Christians, as followers of the Christ, are attended to during these holy days. And of course, it's a big challenge for us. With the pandemic going on, we're not able to gather in groups to celebrate these liturgies. So with this video, I'd like to offer some ways in which you can be present to this wonderful Holy Week, ways in which you can enter more deeply into the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection and what it means for us. So first of all, I encourage you to spend time on our parish website, where we are recording the various liturgies during this Holy Week for Palm Sunday, for Wednesday of Holy Week, Holy Thursday's Mass, the Good Friday liturgy, as well as the Easter Sunday Masses. The one we will not be doing is the Easter Vigil, because it is at that liturgy that we would initiate people into the Catholic Church with initiation sacraments. So those sacraments will have to be celebrated at a later time. So I invite you to, for each specific day, to watch those videos and to prayerfully be present to the sacred mysteries we celebrate on each of these days. Secondly, I invite you to spend some time right around Good Friday with the Passion narrative. That is the story in the Bible of Jesus suffering and his death for us. And I'll give you two options. One would be the Passion narrative according to Matthew, which is chapters 26 and 27 in Matthew's Gospel. And the other choice would be the Passion narrative according to John, which is chapters 18 and 19 in John's Gospel. So read those Passion narratives, either individually or with family members, perhaps different people taking parts of the reading. And I would encourage you to read them aloud, because that involves our sense of hearing as well as our ability to see the sacred text, to make it more of an embodied experience in reading and being present to the narrative in the Gospel. And so this is a way to be present to the saving love of Christ that we celebrate in these sacred days. And I would say, notice the words, the scenes, the images that especially tug at your heart. And just let yourself linger there for a moment, kind of a soaking into what it is that the Lord seems to want to say to you, or to help you to see, or to help you to appreciate in a deeper way by reading these sacred texts. And a third prayerful exercise I would recommend during this Holy Week, as we get closer to Easter itself, is to spend some time with one of the resurrection narratives in the Gospel. Again, to read it out loud, either individually or with family members. And two options. One is the resurrection narrative in Matthew's Gospel, which is chapter 28, or in John's Gospel, chapters 20 and 21. So similarly with the Passion narrative, the resurrection narrative in this prayerful exercise can be a way to be present to how the risen Christ is present to us as individuals and as a community of believers. And so, once again, notice the words, the images, the scenes that seem to tug at your heart, or that seem to linger in your mind during your prayerful exercise. And a fourth prayerful exercise I would recommend is to pray the glorious mysteries. As we get closer to Easter time. I can remember a time back when I was in sabbatical once on Easter Sunday. I was in a parish where we celebrated the Easter Masses. And then I was all by myself because I was far away from home and I was feeling kind of lonely, kind of disconnected from my family because I couldn't gather with them for our big Easter celebration. So what I did was to pray the glorious mysteries in my apartment, to walk around slowly praying those prayers with the rosary. And it became a wonderful experience for me to sense, to know the presence of the risen Christ on that most holy day of Easter. So these are four prayerful exercises I recommend to you as we prepare to enter into the saving mystery of Christ's death and resurrection for us, for our good, for our salvation. Peace to all of you.